eminent people on the dais, and Om Thanvi Sahib, Ashok Vajpayee Sahib, Geeta Hariharan, and Raina Sahib, and all, and very distinguished guests. I have two or three things to say, and I'll start personally. मैं सब अंग्रेजी में बोलूंगा, माफ करें, मुझे सहूलियत है अंग्रेजी में बोलने में. For me, this whole thing started because a rationalist and a fine writer was shot dead. It was not a writer alone who was shot dead. It was rationalization which was shot dead. It was the scientific temper which was shot. And all of us should be shocked at that. And I expected the Academy of Writers, he was a Sahitya Academy award winner. Nothing happened almost for 2 months. There was no outcry, there was no passion, nothing. So I got into all this. Meanwhile, and I'll tell you one thing more, a year and a half back, I had sat at a function with Dabolkar Saab's daughter. For 2 hours we sat, and while the function went on, we kept talking, and she told me all about what had happened. So this stayed very much in my mind. I wish to say two or three things. And then what happened was the murders came along, whether they were on Dadri, and what was worse were the statements. I mean, the moment you start calling it an accident, or the moment an MLA from Muzaffarnagar came and visited the families of the people who had assaulted Akhlaq, rather than visit the house of the victim. This, to me, appeared very weird. And then people called it an accident, and so many statements have come, I don't wish to repeat them. I have already talked about them in papers, if I may say so. Nationalism came up in this country right from the 19th century with Hume and Dadabhai Nauroji, down to Tilak and Gokhale and Rana Day, and then Gandhiji took over. He got in Maulana Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali, the Moplas, the Khilafat movement, everything. Muhammad Ali Jinnah was a part of the freedom movement for a very long time. Let us never forget it. So nationalism was something inclusive, that we are one country and we are against the imperialists and British domination. Today, that very word is being distorted. This happens when politics and people with an ideological bent want to twist something. They first twist language. And we as writers should know how language and when language is twisted. And now it is supposed to be that we are the nationalists and you are the other, something which Nayantara Sehgal has also talked about, that we don't believe that, you know, I don't wish to go what she said, but I entirely and totally agree with her. So this is, you are driving an ideological fissure through the country. Ideological batwara kar rahe hain aap. And this people who are at the top, whether with the government or with parties or with various sansthas, they should think about it. We are asked, why didn't you protest then and why didn't you protest now? Why are you protesting now? Maharashtra was held by a Congress government when Dhab Saab was shot. And this is Muzaffarnagar, held by an SP government. But according to the police, according to the investigations, the sanstha which is doing it, is totally rightist, fundamentalist. So we shouldn't forget the ideology which is driving some lumpens. It is not driving everybody. It is driving a few lumpens into excesses which should be checked. There should be a statement. Nothing of the kind is happening. And you will notice, I talked about the scientific temper. There was in the West, in Europe, etc. I mean, you hardly talk about different countries, and you are people are leaving the church. I'm sorry, I'm not being irreligious. But what I want to say is, whether you are an atheist, whether you believe in one God, or you believe in many, you have a right to have your own views. And you have the right to speak your own views out without anyone threatening you. A climate of fear is what I'm really afraid of. And if you notice, in Asia, we are all going back. I mean, let me be frank, once the Wahhabis were supposed to be the fundamentalists. Today the Wahhabis are being killed because the ISIS, or whatever you call it, the Islamic State, is even more fundamentalist. So we are going back in time. Then we are talking about Vedic science and 100 other things. I don't wish to go into that. But the fact remains, we have to be modern. We have to be contemporaneous. Now, at the end, I want to read out the statement of, not the whole statement, of the scientist, Sri Bhargava. And he said this in 1981, he said, where he said, a statement on scientific temper, that was the essay, and he had said about the country's situation. We are witnessing a phenomenal growth of superstitious beliefs and the obscurantist practices. The influence of various variety of godmen and miracle makers is increasing alarmingly. We know of one man who has been accused of rape, and I think 7 or at least 5 witnesses have been shot dead. Myths are created about our past. Please note this. Myths are created about our past, the origin and role of the caste system is explained in a way that we would justify it and imply that some castes are inherently superior. The ancient period of our history, interpreted to inculcate chauvinism, which is a false pride, the medieval period is misinterpreted in a way that would fan communalism, and the struggle of our people for freedom is oversimplified as if it was the handiwork of a few great leaders and the masses of our people did not matter. So what I suggest to the establishment today is to look up. There are filmmakers who are protesting. There are scientists who are protesting. There are creative writers who have protested. I mean, the intelligentsia is seeing what is actually happening on the ground. And I would very humbly and with great humility tell the establishment to please give them their ear and listen to what they are saying. Thank you.